Well, last week we told you about how scientists have brought back a lost species.
Colossal Biosciences says they have genetically engineered wolves with white hair and muscular jaws, just like the extinct dire wolf. The dogs range from 3 to 6 months old. They're much larger than the gray wolves we see today. Joining us now to talk about it from the Field Museum is paleobiologist Ken Angielczyk. Thanks for being with us.
Good morning.
Yeah, morning. My pleasure.
Well, when we hear... Ken, let me just ask you, when people hear dire wolves, they think of those giant wolves we saw in Game of Thrones. They think this is like some Jurassic Park stuff going on. What's your take on all of this?
Yeah, so it's not quite a real dire wolf. So dire wolves are very large. So here is a dire wolf skull, for instance. And for comparison, here is a modern gray wolf. So you can see it's quite a bit bigger animal. But in reality, they're actually quite distantly related to each other. So the lineage that includes dire wolves diverged from modern wolves like gray wolves about 5.5 million years ago, so quite a long time ago. And the animals that Colossal has genetically engineered have just had a few minor changes made to their genome to make them a little bit bigger and make them look a little bit like a dire wolf. But it's not really like bringing the real extinct species back, unfortunately.
Yeah. So to follow up on Robin's question, the line from Jurassic Park was the scientist asked about, you know, they shouldn't be asking can they do it, they should be asking should they be doing this. And what are your thoughts about whether this kind of thing should be going on?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I guess one of the questions that I have is what the intention of doing it really is. So dire wolves and kind of large mammal predators like that don't really have an easy place to live, at least in North America anymore. And so there's not really a good place to reintroduce them if you think about some of the issues ranchers have with modern wolves, for instance, in places like Wyoming or Montana. You could see how trying to reintroduce dire wolves and even larger predator would be kind of an issue. And so is like the intention for them just to be in zoos or something? So I'm not necessarily sure what the goal was. There's also the issue it costs a lot of money to do this sort of thing. And there's many species that are still alive today that are really being impacted negatively by things like climate change and habitat destruction. And so one question is it better to spend money on trying to preserve those species and do what we can to maintain the biodiversity that we have, as opposed to trying to bring back sort of a facsimile of an extinct animal?
And you also say, you touched on it briefly, but the video that we see, these wolves that were created, they've only recreated, I don't know if I'm saying this correctly, about 14 of the genes out of about 20,000 that would make up this species. So it's not like it's a duplicate, it's not a clone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's correct. So mammal genomes, like wolf genomes, are quite large, so usually about 20 or 25,000 genes. And they've edited about 14 genes. I think they said they made a total of 20 changes in those 14 genes to bring back some of the features like larger body size that we know were characteristic of dire wolves. But overall, it's a very small change. And one analogy that I've used is that it would sort of be like if you took a modern chimpanzee and made a few edits to its genome to make it a little bit bigger and maybe hairless, and then said you brought back Neanderthals.
Wow.
And Ken, let me ask you, is there some kind of benefit to this research, benefit humans in some way? And are there, do you think the government should have laws about doing this?
I think there's potentially some benefits to it, but in sort of more of an experimental way. So it's interesting to know that you can make some changes to the wolf genome to make it more dire wolf-like and what those changes actually result in. So for instance, making the animal larger or giving it sort of a fluffier white coat, that's interesting because that maybe tells us something about the biology of what dire wolves would have been like if we could see them in person. But again, it's not really sort of exactly what they claim to do. In terms of whether there should be laws to do that, I guess I would say that's something that requires more thought. But there's sort of the sort of moral question and kind of the why are you doing this question, and is this really sort of the best use of our resources that I'd say are questions that need to be addressed maybe before making it legal or illegal to do.
Well, Ken, thanks so much for joining us. And, you know, head over to the old Field Museum. Look at all the smart people they have roaming around there. They can answer these questions for you. Thanks, Ken.
Thanks, Ken.
Yeah, my pleasure.
Great job.